Hi everyone. My name is Lena Tkachova. Today I would like to answer a question. And the question is, how to grow the second leg? But what is the second leg? We're constantly saying that delivery is our first powerful leg, the pillar of our business, and that truly is so. Restaurant has always been the second leg, but now it's the time to change, and let me tell you how. The first thing that we needed to do is to tell our guests that actually we do have restaurants. Surprisingly, but not so many people know that we have beautiful, comfortable restaurants. And in the first national advertising campaign that we launched on April 29th, we rapped about the fact that Dodo is good vibes, a place for friends, it's a gallery, but not a museum, and any small pizza is 199. So the ambitious goal of the campaign was to have 1.5 million revenue per restaurant. That was pretty ambitious, but we have earned on average 1.8 dine-in sales per one unit in Russia. And that's only the gallery. Yes, it is possible to earn more compared to QSR, but for us it was growth from March to April of over 31%. And spoiler alert, we have been able to maintain that growth in the following month. So we had two targets, 1.5 average inline sales per unit restaurant, and we have reached that in May. And we had another goal, share of orders from the app of 30%. We have not achieved that yet, because probably it has been overly ambitious. Because it's hardly to change the client's behavior pattern when the client is just used to going to the cashier and making the order there. So we have lowered our target. It's still ambitious, but reachable. So we have corrected the target. But what happened to this figure in the end of May and June? We were in the plateau. About 16% of orders made from the app. And we were growing by decimal points. Probably some of our team members are related to shoemakers because we decided to change our shoes and launch not one ad campaign, but two. I mean, two is better than one. Why not? Turns out when we were shooting the restaurant ad, we also shot the promo to promote the app on the digital. And looks like here you have it, just go and launch it on TV. But turns out it's not that easy. As usually, there were large prices of Moscow in the shot. We needed to deal with legal about that. There were combos that were not for sale anymore. We needed to fix that in legal as well. We needed to change that. There were iteration after iteration to actually confirm the video with the national ad agency. Want to thank our legal team, particularly Madira Sadirova, for making this happen. So, what's next? Another major character. Coronavirus. That's the major character in the shot. In July, Moscow administration introduced limitations to admission to restaurants for non-vaccinated people. So we had to change. We had to change our ad. So it was not about go to a restaurant and hang out there because it's cool. Instead, it was here's the safe way to go to the restaurant and make the order. Win-win. So we began hitting through the plateau. And last week, the share of orders from the app was up to 22%. Of course, Moscow restaurants made an impact. But if we clear out them from the data, turns out it's still over 20%, which is also very significant. But also we have super restaurants that have actually broken through the 30% target. And there are insane restaurants like in Magadan and Gubkinsky with over 40% orders in the restaurant made via the app. Imagine, almost a half. This is just awesome. Another important figure is that our monthly app installs have increased by 50% both for organic and non-organic traffic in April compared to March. And in June, we have also grown in terms of app installs. That is also great. Why? Because the app not only fosters orders in the restaurant, but also delivery, because you can make an order there as well, in the app too. But of course, the restaurants are powerful not only with national campaigns. We're actually improving three major branches: trade marketing, operations, and our services. In trade marketing, we're promoting the app like it's the last thing we do. But we're not doing that in a chaotic way. We have dedicated QR code for every sort of promo material, so we evaluate the efficiency of every single one of them, trying to reject the least efficient and promote the most efficient. You would imagine that TV board at the entrance to the restaurant, or a sticker on the floor would have the greatest conversion for app installs. But no, turns out the receipt, the check, is the promo item that has the best conversion for app installs. As for operations, we improved it as well. Now Olinka speaks in a new way and sometimes even louder. Orders are highlighted. And we have launched RN Digital for dine and orders. Olinka is our voice assistant, by the way. We've also updated our RN Digital with the opportunity to track every order. Now the restaurant administrator can figure out why certain orders were delivered very quickly and others were not. So we can systematically improve the quality of products right in the restaurant. And of course, client service. How can we do without it? On Thursday, Bore told you about all of the changes that we've made in the Q3. Let me highlight just a few of them, the most significant ones. The first one being the launch in Kazakhstan and Belarus. We launched on June 3rd, prepared the materials, tested everything in a test environment, synced with our partners, and launched it. On the graph here, you see the three countries moving head-to-head from one week to the other. In terms of orders made through the app, share of orders, looks like Russia is ahead in week 4. That's mainly related to the launch of the national ad campaign, while in Belarus and Kazakhstan, we see very gradual increase because the guys have not been investing a lot in the promo of the app. You guys, you really should. So start doing that. Next, the change that we've made in terms of geo. That's the hygiene for the order, both for delivery and for the restaurant. And our geo and Ninja++ teams have radically improved this one. What matters is 80% that we have now made through the app have been made when the person is in the restaurant. The trade marketing that we are doing, like it's the last thing we do, truly works. Another important point, the launch of this section, you will like it. That truly is an MVP that we have launched very quickly. But now 18% of the orders are made with the products in this you will like it section. Another important feature, we have added new categories, coffee and cocktails. Can you remember the last time we were adding new categories to the menu? Probably it was a combo. Now we have tested this one and we see that we have 5% more sales of coffee only in the app. How cool is that? And we have rectified the pickup time. We had only one button there. Make it quick. But define quick. Quick is different for everything and everybody. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 or 25 or an hour. We have added the time that is relevant for a particular product in the order. For example, if a person orders a coffee, then make it quick would be up to five minutes. If it's a set of products that need to be cooked in the kitchen, that's up to 15 minutes. And for example, if the order is for a big number of pizzas, that may be even up to 25 minutes. This is what we're doing now. But what's in the future? We want to make the best app for the order, both in the restaurant and for the delivery. And here's the pool of hypotheses that we want to test right now. First of all, table service. Tips not only for delivery guys, but also for cashiers. Redesign menu. More fluid and quick app so that the clients understand truly that it's much faster to make an order in the app. We want to add more hot and ready products and more pieces and slices. Also, we want to improve communication about conscious consumption in the flow of the order of the app. Of course, there are some limitations that are still maintained. Of course, sales in the restaurants in Moscow fell by 50%, and that hurts. But we were not hindered in the first wave of COVID when there was a full lockdown and everything was closed. We still improved our app and we're preparing the national campaign about the restaurants. And we're not going to stop this time either. We're going to improve our app. And next year, we're going to launch 2 ad campaigns about the restaurants. And since you know how much we love to change our shoes, let's make it 4.